welcome on our STM32Cube IDE Basics training session. In this section, I will demonstrate how to use UART to send the data and how to visualize it using the terminal, which is built in within the STM32Cube IDE tool. So the objectives of this part are the following. I will demonstrate how to configure the UART tool in asynchronous mode to send the data, and then how we can reuse existing connection between UART tool of our microcontroller from the Nucleo board to ST-Link, and then to use a virtual COM port on PC to communicate with the micro. And then we will reuse existing built-in terminal application, which is a part of STM32Cube IDE. Let's start from STM32Cube IDE new project creation. I would reuse an existing workspace, which contains already several projects. I would create a new one for our micro. So I go to File, New, STM32 project, and now I'm waiting for the target selection window. I'm selecting STM32 G071 RB microcontroller, so it's enough to type G071 RB. This is this one, and we are selecting LQFP64 package version. So I create click next, then the name of the project. I would propose G0 USART, and I will select C as a target language. I would like to generate the executable binary type, and we will use STM32Cube and its device configuration to create the skeleton of the application. Let's click finish to start a device configuration window, which is in fact STM32CubeMX, built in within STM32Cube IDE complete environment. So we see on the left side that our new project is already created, G0 USART. It's an empty skeleton. So now we can see the complete pinout of our micro. Nothing is connected yet. So let's start from connection of the debug interface, so system core sys serial wire. We see that two pins has been already assigned, so this is the first point. Then we need to connect UART 2, which is connected internally to the ST-Link. So we go to the connectivity, UART 2, we select asynchronous mode. And then we see that PA2 and PA3 are assigned to UART2 TX and RX functions. And those two pins are connected to ST-Link on the ST-Link UART, and then are visible with a virtual COM port on PC once we connect our Nucleo board to PC. Okay, so we've got a connection to UART, and now we can configure our UART parameters. So let's configure the parameters. I would propose to keep 115,000 bits per second as a baud rate. Work length, it's including parity. I would use 8 bits, and let's use even parity. Let's keep stop bits to 1 as a default settings. We will not do any additional configuration. So we can generate the project. I will just save the projects by Control S. So there is a question whether we would like to generate the code. I would click remember my decision and select yes. On the left part of the screen, we can see that our template is filled with newly generated source files. Okay, so now we need to go into the source and the main.c file, which is the main file containing the sources which are executed after the reset. And within the main procedure, we can see that we've got some initial configuration within the hull init, then the clock configuration, which we kept as a default setting. So our system is clocked by HSI, so high-speed internal oscillator, which is 16 megahertz. And then we've got initialization of the GPIOs and our UART 2. What we need to do right now, we need to transmit in some area data over the UCERT. So to do this, I would use our while one loop, where I would put the function from UCERT domain. So hal underscore UART control space. And now I can see a lot of functions which are typical for G0 family, those with suffix EX, but I would select something typical, something easy. So I would like to transmit something without any IT, without any DMA. So I would select just simple hal UART transmit. The first argument is a handler to the UART we would like to use. Then the pointer to the data we would like to send, then the size of those data, and the timeout in milliseconds we would like to wait till the function will complete. So the first one will be UART2. The second one, instead of the buffer, I would just specify the name. It would be test space, and the size it's 5 letters plus the end of the string, so it will be 6, and the timeout, let's put for example 100 milliseconds. Okay, to be sure that the function would be executed correctly without any errors, I would propose to check its return value, and in case of any trouble, let's call the function which is already generated, its error handler. It can be called in all of the cases when the hal function is returning value different from hal OK, which is the proper execution of the hal function. Okay, so I use if, then it's not equal hal OK, then execute error. I will just correct the typing. Okay. To not block our microcontroller, I would use some delay function at the end. Hal delay. Let's put here 500 milliseconds to make this string display visible. Okay, so this is all from the coding side. Let's try to compile the code. So I would build it. Okay, and now let's try to run a debug session. I select STM32MCU C++ application. This is the time I can change some configuration within the debug. I keep the default settings. And now I will switch to the debug perspective. Now we need to turn on the terminal window. And now, being in a console window, now we are in a debug perspective, so we can see the dedicated debug tab with resume, pause, so suspend and terminate debug session. In the bottom, we can see the window with set of tabs. So console, registers, memory, outputs. We can set more registers tabs. And important is to select the console window, console tab. If you do not see any console, you can go to the window, show view, and console. Within the console tab, you need to go to the open console and select command shell console. Then select serial port, select new, select any connection type. So I would select test G0, then a serial port, which has been assigned to your Nucleo port. In my case, it is COM31. Baud rate, like set in our configuration within the device configuration, so it was 115,000. Data size, it was set to 8, including parity, so I would set to 7, because we are using even parity. And the stop bits is 1. I click finish. I can select as well the encoding, one of the three options we've got here, but I do not use any special characters, so I use the default setting, and then I press OK. So I can see that my terminal is connected. Now, if I run the application by pressing the resume button, I can see once per half a second the text I would like to display. Now I can disconnect the terminal, just pressing this icon. I can connect it once again. It will continue. Please be careful once you disconnect the terminal and then you forget to close the console. Because in this case, if you try to create a new terminal application, it will be not possible. It will be not possible because there is already open connection on different name, on the same serial port. Thank you for watching this video.